Welcome to Humiseal here at Productronica. I'm delighted to be joined by David Greenman. Nice to see you then, David.
And you, Trevor. Okay.
So, just a few weeks ago, David, we spoke in India about your new sharp-edged definition conformal coating, which you were going to release at Productronica.
Absolutely, and we are releasing it.
Okay.
And we're doing live demonstrations.
Really? So, you're going to take us over to the other side of the booth, and we're going to watch the demonstration.
Yes, Mr. Chris Brightwell, our R&D manager, is going to give you a full overview of the product, how it works, and how it protects the board against all environments.
Excellent, excellent.
Okay right, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. What we're going to look at today, we're going to look at a new type of coating which is being introduced by Humiseal at the show, Productronica, today. We all know about conformal coatings. We know when they're used. They're used to protect against corrosive environments. They're used to protect against humidity, moisture, condensation, and to increase the reliability of electronic assemblies. They've been available on the market for 50 years, but over the last few years, people are starting to see the original designs perform less well in more rigorous test environments. The test environments that most notoriously are difficult to pass are these new condensation tests, where powered boards are placed into an environment where condensation will appear on the board. It will lead to possible board malfunction or failure. So the team at Humiseal have been working to develop new coatings, which we're calling SEC coatings, standing for sharp edge coverage coatings. Can everybody hear me? Okay.
Not perfect.
Good enough. I will talk even louder. So what I'm going to show first, I'm going to demonstrate a board which has got no coating on at all. So this board here so there's no conformal coating on this. And this test board, they are surface mount components, and each component is not connected to its adjacent component. And I'm going to immerse this component in water droplets, and we're going to see leakage current between adjacent components. So first I'm going to show the problem of not having any conformal coating on your board. Thank you, my able assistant. We've got three multimeters here, and the multimeters are showing, is there any leakage current between different types of components? So this multimeter here is showing leakage component between adjacent 0804 capacitors. This multimeter is showing leakage between adjacent 0603 resistors. This multimeter is showing leakage current between adjacent 0804 resistors. And so OL means very high resistance. So let's imagine that the circuit, this circuit board, is being used in a humid environment, and then can transfer from a humid hot environment to a humid cool environment. Condensation may appear on the electronics, and it may lead to malfunction. So I will create condensation by spraying a little bit of water onto the circuit board. But at first I'm just going to protect the board, just so I don't get water into the connector. So the board has gone from a hot, steamy environment to a cold environment, and condensation appears. See that the components are starting to fail. We're starting to see leakage current between adjacent components. This is the fundamental issue with coatings with poor coverage. So next I'm going to show you. Next I'm going to show you a board which has got a traditional coating on. So we have a circuit board which is coated with a traditional conformal coating. We can see the conformal coating on the board. when the board is dry, there is no leakage current between adjacent components. The board is now exposed to an environment where moisture collects on the board. And we see this effect that the large components, the 0804 components, the 0804 capacitors and the 0804 resistors, we are seeing no resistance between them. There is complete failure. The 0603 components, they're smaller components and they have got better protection. And this is a feature that users of coatings are seeing more, that as the components get bigger, we are getting worse sharp edge coverage. So now what I want to show you is an example of a new class of coating. So now this is a new class of coating. We are calling them SEC coatings, which stands for sharp edge coverage. This is a synthetic rubber coating, and it is the coverage of these components. The coverage of the it's applied like a regular coating, but it will completely protect all the corners of the boards. Okay, so the board has gone into a condensing environment. We've got water droplets on the board. Now we see good resistance between all the different types of components on board. Okay, right. To completely prove the how resistant these coatings are to water, I want to do a slightly more extreme test. I'm going to immerse the board. 24 volts on the components into water, and we're going to look for leakage current between the components. So as a demonstration, I can't see, does it say 24 volts here?
Yes.
It does, thank you. So this is going into a beaker of deionized water first. I guess now I'm seeing leakage current.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to pour salt into the beaker of water, and I'm going to immerse the circuit board in the salt water. I think we can see we've got over 2 amps of leakage current, and we can see that the board has failed and is starting to. So again, this is the board I showed you earlier, which we sprayed water droplets onto. That's right. We'll assume it's okay. This one is the deionized water. Do we see any current flow? No. So this board is coated with Humiseal 1B59 SEC, and it's powered up to 24 volts, and I'm going to put it into a beaker of tap water and see if there's any leakage current. I see no leakage current. And now I'm going to put it into a beaker of salt water and look for leakage current. So I think we can see here that this board is providing complete protection of this board. There was no perceivable leakage current, despite the fact it was immersed in salt water at 24 volts. And if we take a look at the board, we can see the material is hydrophobic. The water hasn't wetted the board. There is no negative effect of that board, despite the fact it has been put in a 10% salt solution. Okay. So we've got two new materials that we're promoting, 1B59 SEC, which is a synthetic rubber material, and 1A33 SEC, which is a polyurethane material. Both these materials They can be applied like a regular coating with selective spray processes, and they provide this high level of protection that I've demonstrated to you today. They can be film coated and they can be spray coated, and we are working on dip coat versions as well.
Okay, David, thank you very much for that demonstration. It's very interesting and obviously very conclusive. So the protection afforded by the new SEC, yeah, that's correct, is obviously very comprehensive. I mean, there literally was no leakage at all shown in that latest demonstration. So congratulations, and we wish you every success with it.
Thank you very much, Trevor. It's been a pleasure to demonstrate the product and work with you again.
Thank you.